And welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm Shimli and today's video is going to be a reading wrap up. This is my first ever reading wrap up, so I'll only be mentioning the books that I've read till May end, but anyways, consider this as a mid-year reading wrap up. I wish to read about 50 books this year. Let's hope that I'm able to reach my reading goal. And in this video, I will be talking about the 15 books that I've read so far this year. So let's begin with the video. Okay, so the beginning of the year was not how I wanted it to be. I lost my grandfather, hence I couldn't read as much as I wanted to. And I also feel that when I am not in a good headspace, I cannot focus on reading. The first book that I picked up this year is this one, Icebreaker by Hannah Grace, and I regret picking this one. I also think that this book was the reason why I couldn't read as much as I wanted to, because while I was reading this one, I went through a very bad reading slump. It was like I was not interested in reading anything, maybe because of this one, because there was no story. I don't know how this can be a highly rated book on Bookstagram and even on Goodreads also. As I mentioned, there was no plot. The two main characters are already into each other within the first 100 or 150 pages, and the entire story is then just smut, nothing else. But I was looking for something very chill and not Wattpad-y and not full of smut, so that is the reason why I did not enjoy this one. I think I rated it a 2.5 star, but I think that I should have rated it less, maybe 2. I absolutely did not like this book. And this is also the first book of the Maple High series, and I'm not sure if I'll read the other two books. But I've also heard that Wildfire, which is the next book of this series, is better than this one. I'm not sure. I might read it in future. I might skip it. I want to make a pile so that it's visible. This year, I have also decided that I'll listen to more audiobooks because it's entertaining. While I'm working, I can play an audiobook, I can do my work, and I will also be able to read more. So that is one thing that I am actively trying to do this year. So the first audiobook that I listened to this year was the first book of the Hunger Games series, and I loved it. I don't think that I need to mention anything separately for the Hunger Games series. I was watching that movie, and that is when I thought, okay, let's also listen to the audiobook. The third book that I picked up this year is this one, Once Upon a Broken Heart, first book from the Once Upon a Broken Heart trilogy. Now, honestly, I do not remember the story of this one, or maybe you can say that I was just skimming through the books. I was not actually reading, but I remember little bit, so I'll mention as much as I can. So we are following this girl who lost her father recently, and she deals with a cruel prince. So this girl's stepsister is getting married to this girl's boyfriend, or the love of her life. So she's heartbroken. She goes to this church where she meets this cruel prince. We get to know more about this prince, the backstory of his history, has that fairy tale thing. If you still cannot understand, I used to love fairy tale as a child, so I'll reread this obviously this year. Maybe I'll try to reread this again. I kind of felt that this was like Cinderella retelling. I might be wrong, so I'll reread this because I want to read the other two books in this series. And I think I rated it a 3 star, which also makes me think that I should film reading wrap-ups more often so that I don't forget the plots. Anyways, that was the third book. While I was reading this book, I was also listening to the audiobook of Hating Games. Hating Games is also a Netflix movie or a Netflix series. I've not watched the movie or the series. I've just listened to the audiobook. It has a forced proximity, enemies to lovers, trope, set up in an office. I loved it. I loved the banter between the two main characters. Obviously, it has the cheesy romance thing. Girl character and the main boy character, they both hate each other, they cannot stand each other. Also, listening to the audiobook made me feel good at that time. I rated it a 4 star. It was good, but I don't think that I'll specifically recommend that book to somebody because it did not leave any mark. But if you are looking for a chill romance novel, a very light book, you can go for this one. Let's talk about the fifth book that I picked up this year, which is this one. And I think I have mentioned this book already 10 times on this channel. I loved it so much. This, as you can see, is a very tiny book and perfect for someone who is going through a reading slump. And this book literally helped me fall in love with reading again. And the storyline of this book also follows a 20 something year old girl, which made this book extra relatable. She moves to her uncle's place to help him run his old bookstore, so we also get that cozy bookstore vibes, which I love. So while she was staying with her uncle and while she was helping him run his bookstore, she falls in love with reading and discovers that reading can solve a lot of problems problems in your life because you can just escape the reality. This was also the first 5-star book of this year. I picked this one very randomly. I did not read any reviews or did not watch any reels on this one. But once I finished reading this, I saw many Instagram reels talking about this book, and most of these reels were negative. So this book is divided into two parts. I agree to them thoda sa. I can understand where they are coming from. I agree that the first part of the book was little slow, but this book is also based on Japanese culture. Japanese culture is in general very slow. So if you love Japanese culture, I think that you will love this book. Also, it was just 140 or 145 pages. I don't think that there is much more to talk about. If you are a beginner, this book is perfect. So the next one for me was this one, In Other Words by Jhumpa Lahiri. This is my first Jhumpa Lahiri book and I loved it. The writing was so simple, so easy to understand. She is also Bengali. Maybe that is another reason why I love this book. She is bilingual, just like me, but trying to learn a new language, trying to learn Italian as a language. That is the reason that she moves to Rome, to understand the culture better. She also thinks that to understand a culture, you need to learn the language, which is something that I agree to. I live away from home. The people here, they speak different language, and sometimes I don't feel included just because I cannot speak their language. And you can also say that this is almost like a love letter from Jhumpa Lahiri to the language. I have not read autobiography or books where the author is sharing his or her experience. So this was the first time. So maybe that is the reason why I did not enjoy it. But I love this one, and it also made me buy more Jhumpa Lahiri books. I started listening to the audiobook of 8 Perfect Murders, and this is the time when I got into my cozy murder mystery era. I started listening and reading murder mystery thrillers. I loved this one. This book actually pushed me to start reading mystery books. So in this book, we are following an owner of an old bookstore, specifically deals with mystery books. And this man years ago wrote a blog post talking about his favorite murder mystery books, since he is the owner of a mystery only bookstore. So someone is killing people around town following the books that he has mentioned in that particular blog post, and he's also following the books in a serial order. I loved listening to the audiobook. I think that listening to the audiobook or reading that book on a rainy day will be so good. I want to also read that book. I want to get the physical copy. So that was about 8 Perfect Murders. After this one, I started listening to Dead Romantics by Ashley Poston. So Dead Romantics is a very wholesome book. If you are looking for something unusual, different from the usual trope that we read, I have not read the other book by the author, The 7-Year Slip, but it's on my reading TBR for this year. The main character and her father, both of them can see ghosts, but her father recently passed away. That is the reason why she moves to her hometown. They also run a funeral home. It is such a wholesome book. You can say that the book is rom-commy, but also shows how people process grief. I loved it so much. As I mentioned that I was in a mood to read more thrillers, the next book that I picked up is also a murder mystery thriller. It's this one, The Housemaid by Freda McFadden. I loved this book. It is the next 5-star read for the year. I stayed up all night trying to finish this book. It took me some time to get into this one, but after the first 100 pages, I ate it up. It was so good. It was so entertaining. I was hooked. You will surely not be bored while reading this one. On every page, something new is happening. You are getting more background, more story, more history about the characters. For this one, we are following a married couple, a very rich married couple who hires a housemaid who has criminal records, and this particular girl, the house help, and then starts living in this huge mansion. Now this house help is allotted a very tiny room, but this room is also very creepy. If you see closely, we have this keyhole thing on the cover, and this room is very dark. Only one fridge, only one bed, there was a bucket. The door can only be locked from outside, and from there the main story starts. I don't want to talk about this book anymore, but I don't want to give away a lot. This is one of the books that I will keep recommending to people, including non-readers in my life. Let's move on to the next book. The next book is also a thriller book, which is this one. I started reading Verity by Colleen Hoover. Now I am very sure that you must have seen this book somewhere on the internet. Verity will soon be a movie, so before it comes out as a movie, I wanted to read this. I think I rated it a 5-star, but now I think that I should have rated this a 4.5-star. It is not as good as The Housemaid. housemate is top-notch. In Verity, we are following this barely struggling author who is struggling to pay her bills, loses her mother recently, and suddenly someone reaches out to her to continue writing an already existing, already ongoing series because the author cannot write anymore, and discovers a manuscript written by that other author. The manuscript is very creepy. Verity is the name of the other author who has written the manuscript. If you are in a mood or something, a creepy, dark, mystery thriller, you can give this one a try. I'm very sure that you will love this one. And also, I think this is the only thriller book written by Colleen Hoover. So I was still in my murder mystery mood, and I started listening to the audiobook of The Reappearance of Rachel Grace by Holly Jackson. Reappearance of Rachel Price is a new book, and I very randomly started listening to the audiobook. So this one book was recommended to me on Storytel, and I started listening to this, and I think I rated it a 4-star or 4.5 star. I could not predict what will happen in the next chapter, but I was so hooked. So we are following a 16-year-old teenager named Belle, and Belle's mother suddenly vanishes. We have no idea where she is, where she went for 16 years, and then suddenly one day she comes back. There's a lot of family drama involved. Get to know more about the family drama, family dynamic, family politics. A lot of drama is involved. If you are in a mood to read mystery, which also includes family drama, I think you should give this book a try. I am seeing recently this book a lot on Instagram. Next, I was in a mood of fluffy romance book, and I picked this one up. Better Than Movies. This is a very cutesy romance novel. I've heard so many good things about this, and I wanted to read this for a really long time. So glad that I gave this book a try. I loved it so much. If you are on BookTube, you must have seen Hailey Pham's video. She loves this book, and now I can understand why she loves this one. And I recommended this one to one of my friends, my only reader friend, and she loved it so much. She finished reading this one in a day. That is how good this book is. I also finished reading this one within 2 days. Every chapter starts with references from rom-com movies. I usually don't watch movies, but mostly when I watch movies, I prefer watching rom-com movies. So if you watch rom-com movies, if you love rom-com movies, you will surely love this one. So our main character is a high school teenage girl. It is set in a very small town, and our main character, childhood crush, returns to this small town. It is also an enemies to lovers trope. I cannot stop talking about this one. I loved it so much. If I've not mentioned it already, it was a 5-star for me. The last physical book that I read this year so far, it is this pretty book, A Code of Mist and Fury. It is the second book from the ACOTAR series. I recommend everybody to start reading ACOTAR series. I want to read the other 3 books in this series. I want to get the books next month. Hopefully I'll get them. First up, every book in this series looks so pretty. I don't know if I should talk about the plot of this one. If I talk about the plot of this one, I'll also have to mention the first book. You might not have read the first book, so I don't want to talk about this one. All I want to say is that Reese is a gentleman. I love Reese. I already hated Tamlin in the first book. Give this book a try if you want to get into fantasy. It was the last physical book that I read. After this, I went ahead to listening to one audiobook, which is by Ruskin Bond. It is the book How to Live Your Life. It was a so tiny book. I think the length of the audiobook was about 40 or 30 minutes. It felt like a letter from an old grandfather. I had a grandfather, and it is such a warm book. A grandfather is talking about how you should live your life, what you should do, things you should avoid, things you should eat. It was such a good book. It made me think about my grandpa. Maybe that is the reason I loved it so much. I think that even if you are not a reader, you can listen to the audiobook. It was so cute. Now let's talk about the last book for this video, which is, I always get confused with the name, Same Summer Next Time. The name of the book is Same Time Next Summer. It's a book by Annabel Morgan. I loved it so much. It was again a romance novel. I think it's perfect for a beach vacation. I am not a beach girly, but after reading this book, I want to go to a beach just for the vibes. The main character is in her early 30s. Soon she will get married, and that is when she again meets with her childhood boyfriend. You can understand what will happen. Plot is predictable, but we are following past timelines, and then we are coming back to the present timeline, so we are going back and forth. There's a lot of surfing included, island hopping, beach parties, which are something that I have never experienced in my life yet, but I want to. I rated it a 4.5 star, and if you are looking for a summer read, summer perfect beach read, you can go for this one. So with that, we have reached the end of this video. I hope that you loved watching this video. Hopefully, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.